For me, I'll stand with the people of Zambia. I'll stand with President Hakainde
Hichilema. Even if the UPND say they're going to find, like you're saying, cooperative opportunities for them, you still won't be convinced.
My friend, and I want to tell the UPND, if they're listening, that this is the time the people of Zambia look at them as jokers. And they will never be trusted anymore. I posted an issue about the cadres on my Facebook page. For the first time, the 2.8 million supported me. And you know how they've been so, you know, for now, they don't want you to talk about any negativity. But when I said, to say, gentlemen, the issues of cadres going back in the market is a non-starter. Let's avoid that. They supported me. You understand?
All right. As we conclude, the president is expected to speak today. Apart from this issue of the cadrism that Minpa hoping is going to touch on, as Sasida, what else do you expect or would you love the president to address today?
Number one, the president should come out very, very, very strong and clear to the people of Zambia to give a position on the issue of gay rights in Zambia. This is a topic, and this is a serious topic that we are looking forward as young people, because we've never seen such since independence up to today. But there are strong rumors that this Tony Blair who came, he came for the same. And there have been rumors even the time the UPND was in the opposition. So for us, we are looking at President Hakainde Hichilema to come out clear, so like President Lungu, the way he said, to say he does not support. And if there are people, the white people, that thinks they can control us by giving us money to fund, you know, our government here and there, President Lungu put it on.
So even if the vice president has spoken about it, the chief government spokesperson has spoken about it, you're not convinced about it.
Those issues of vice president and the chief whatever, those are people for us. We don't even look at them as people with a decision. The decision comes from the president. So let the president, whom the people voted for, give a position.
Okay.
Second, we want to see the president, you know, it's high time that he should give a time frame from each and every promise that he has given to the people of Zambia. Number one, the issue of free education is a matter that every parent is looking forward because they voted in numbers. Second, as an association, we have been struggling to help pupils who are in grade 12 that have passed with 6, 8, 7, 8, 9 points, failing to make it to go to university. We want to see a policy on how President Hakainde Hichilema, who managed to take each and every student to university. Second, it's the meal allowance. He promised the student to say, I'll give you back the meal allowance. And when I sell a jet, I'll increase the BC, which is the same meal allowance, from the amount which they were getting, to elevate it so that it can be, you know, because that money, to be honest with you, students use it for other things. They even use it to just feed their families back home in the village, like as far as Chama village. You understand? So those are the things that we want to see the president today to say, in my next budget, I want to employ 20,000 teachers. In my next budget, I want to employ 10,000 nurses.
Okay.
In my budget, I want to employ more police officers because there is no manpower. Those are things as young people that we are looking forward to see.
Okay.
We want to have a direction with a time frame, not just a song. You know, understand? So as young people, we gave him a vote. We turned the numbers. Let him give us a roadmap as we continue supporting him. And we have the confidence in him. But what we can only advise President Hakainde Hichilema that if he does not fix our problems, we are going to fix him.